Well, Minnesota's home to the largest Karen community in the country, a community that suffered persecution and oppression in their homeland for decades. Jasmine Boykin shows us how St. Paul schools are doing their best to keep the Karen culture strong in tonight's Lifting Voices.
Like, you have to start from the scratch. You have to learn everything from the scratch.
Adapting to life in the United States can be difficult, from learning a new language to learning a new culture.
I mean, I feel like until now, I'm still learning. I don't know a lot of things. Society and the way people interact with each other here is a little bit different.
Etaku is Karen, an ethnic group who called Myanmar home until the Burmese majority gained control of the country and they had to flee. That was after World War II.
They would come out and like burned out the villages, killing and torturing the civilians.
To this day, the regime is doing its best to eradicate the Karen culture.
Nearly 8,000 miles away, the Karen language is banned in all public schools in Myanmar. But here at Washington Magnet, students will be able to learn both a culture and a language unlike any other.
And with 2,500 students in the St. Paul district who identify as Karen, that's huge news, especially for Harding High freshman Ginny So, who's hoping this will help her connect with her family, especially her elders.
Sometimes I go to appointments with my grandpa, and there's been many moments where they might ask me something, and I give what they're saying, and I'm trying to translate, but I don't know how, because there's a lot of words in Karen that I don't know how to say. It makes me feel kind of hopeless.
Not only that, but she knows it's an opportunity for others to learn more about who she is at her core.
When I was younger, not a lot of people knew about the Karen like culture and just Karen people in general.
The new program teaching the Karen language isn't just about spoken word. It's about keeping an entire people, a culture, alive.
There's a Karen say that if we lose our language, we lose our nation, we lose our people.
In St. Paul, Jasmine Boykin, KARE 11 News.
The language classes will be held in person at four schools, including Washington and Harding. It will also be online for all St. Paul High School students, and it starts this fall.